Now that we know the three types of elements that we have in the periodic table, it becomes important to be able to name the groups. And what exactly is a group? Now, if we take a look here, we're going to say this is 1A, 2A, 3A, 4A, 5A, 6A, 7A, 8A. These are called your main groups. Okay? Groups go vertical. Okay? So we're going to say that there are eight main groups. These are also called our representative elements, our main group elements. Now, down here in the pit, these are also groups, but they're not A groups, they're B groups. Okay, so these are our B group elements. They're not representative elements. What they're called instead is that they're called transition metals. You'll learn later on in the semester why they call transition metals, because a majority of these metals will have more than one charge. That's why they're called transition metals. They can transition from one state to another state in terms of charge. Later on in this chapter, we'll talk about the charges that these different groups hold and why they hold those charges. So again, groups 1A to 8A are called your main group metals or your representative metals. In the pit, we have our group B elements, which are your transition metals. These two columns here are also transition metals, these guys here. Now, we're going to say each one of the many of these representative groups also have special names associated with them. We're going to say that group 1A, these elements here are called your alkali metals. Alkali metals. Okay. Hydrogen would be an exception. Hydrogen is not a metal, so it's not an alkali metal. It's a non-metal. We're going to say that the alkali metals are highly reactive. If you took, for example, if you had a piece of sodium metal, pure sodium, and you dunked it into water, what would happen is that it would have a violent explosion with that water. And as you go down this group to K or RB, if you take those and throw it into water, the reactions will be even more violent, leading to bigger explosions. That's why it's very hard to get a sample of these pure group 1A elements. You can't just go to any store and get some. They're under lock and key, very hard to get to. Group 2A, they're called your alkaline earth metals. 3A and 4A and 5A, we don't have names for them. They don't have any general names to them. 6A, group 6A, they're called your chalcogens. 7A, they're called your halogens. 8A, they're called your noble gases or inert gases. Inert just means they don't react with anything. Very unreactive. So alkaline metals are super reactive. Inert gases are very unreactive. So they're on opposite ends of the periodic table for a reason. Okay. Now we're going to say that these two columns here also have names. We're going to say that this row here, so all of this right here, these are called your lanthanides. And then this row here, these are called your actinides. They're also transition metals, but they have special names associated with them. So we've seen the division of the periodic table in terms of metals, metalloids, and nonmetals. We've just seen that groups go vertical up and down. That's a group. Groups 1A to 8A are your representative elements or main group elements. A majority of them have a special name associated with them. In the pit, we call those our transition metals or our group B elements.